This next item made a lot of U.S. consumers sit up and take notice today. Bluefin tuna caught off the California coast have been found to contain elevated levels of radioactive matter dating back to the Japanese earthquake and tsunami that led to that nuclear accident at the Fukushima power plant.
The 15 bluefin tuna caught and tested off California's coast last summer showed low levels of radiation, but still 10 times higher than normal. Scientists say it's the first time a fast-moving migrating fish has been shown to carry radioactivity from Japanese waters.
We almost didn't believe it, to tell you the truth.
Dr. Nicholas Fisher, professor of marine sciences, co-authored the study.
Every single fish was significantly contaminated with two radioisotopes of cesium. And these are common waste products from nuclear accidents.
All the way in Maine, which may or may not be related, they have shut down the shrimp season for 2014. Just shut it down. Listen, they've been studying for 24 years the ocean floor. And instead of 1% to 2%, 98%. Listen, 98% of the Pacific Ocean floor is littered with dead creatures. Along with the starfish disintegrating and the jellyfish, the squid, every bluefin tuna tested in the Pacific Ocean is inedible due to radiation. This is all within the 3 years of Fukushima, and I don't know whose eyes they want to pull the wool over that they're not related. Before March 2011, they didn't ban them for radiation, didn't use Geiger counters in their supermarkets. Every bluefin tuna tested in the Pacific Ocean is inedible due to radiation. This is all within the 3 years of Fukushima.
Bluefin tuna caught off the California coast have been found to contain elevated levels of radioactive matter.
Every bluefin tuna tested in the Pacific Ocean is inedible due to radiation.
Every single fish was significantly contaminated with two radioisotopes of cesium.
The current axial tilt of the Earth is calculated approximately 49 degrees. Okay, out of 360, you might go, well, big deal, Marco. That's only an extra 26 degrees. 26? That's more than double our normal tilt that takes 26,000 years. And in 3 years, we've more than doubled our tilt.
This answers every single question that they won't tell you on mainstream news. There's not one of these issues that isn't attributable to where you live is now in a different place than where you used to live. The former polar ice cap on the North Pole. There's no Santa pole, red and white pole in the ice. There's no reindeer. There's nothing marking the North Pole except a buoy in the water. The former polar ice cap on the North Pole is now a lake. Is now a lake. Is now a lake.
There's a buoy in the water.
Is now a lake.
Is now a lake.
Now a lake.
Now a lake. Now a lake.
Mr. Van V turned at the onsen's blade.
Merry Christmas! I'm sorry, but Santa's request line has been canceled this year on account of the North Pole has melted due to the solar flares getting through the cracks in the magnetosphere. Oh, ho, ho, ho. Besides, Santa's toy shop will be obliterated when Planet X smashes into the North Pole next week, anyways. Oh, ho, Merry Christmas! The North Pole has melted.
A former polar ice cap on the North Pole is now a lake.
And there's a lot of water right off your coast, Dr. Hildy, in L.A. It's a lot of water.
A lot of water.